Denver Radio Real Estate with Cheryl Garlock, a show about all things real estate and home-related in Denver and Colorado. Covering topics from buying to selling a home, construction, financing, foreclosures, and more. Helping the consumer to be educated and informed. Here's your host, Cheryl Garlock.
Hey, hey, hey. Welcome to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, your host, and thank you so much for joining us. You know, this is the first time our show has been on the air here, and I want to go ahead and tell you what you can expect to find out. This show is all about residential real estate. So, you know, if you're thinking about buying a home, selling a home, or investing in a home, you want to learn the ins and outs of all these different things here, because we've got a rocking market that's coming up on us here in 2014, and you guys know the market has changed. This is the place where you can go ahead and find all that information out. Now, let me give you a phone number to call if you got questions here, because that's what I'm here for. I want to answer your questions. 720-373-0654. 720-373-0654. And you can always visit me at denverrealty.com. Now, I have guests that come to this show, and today I have Chris Zadra with WJ Bradley. Did I say that right, Chris?
Yes.
Oh, I finally got it right here. Practice makes perfection,
absolutely,
doesn't it, here?
Absolutely.
So, you know, I am already dressed in my team blazing colors of Bronco orange, right?
Love it, love it.
Love it. We got Bronco fever going on. I know you guys have got a lot of things to do this weekend here, and that is definitely one part of it there. So we are hoping for a great victory here on Sunday, aren't we?
Absolutely.
You know that. So listen, you guys, I need some help. I've got a buyer. I want you to help me out here because I've hardly combed the MLS, you know, our multiple listing service there, extensively. And this buyer is looking to kind of basically sell her single family home and, you know, downsize, that concept of downsizing. And she would like to get a condo downtown, like a two-bedroom, maybe three-bedroom condo, you know, maybe two baths, roomy, needs to have some room to it, views. But we're talking down central downtown Capitol Hill area near the Capitol building, all that jazz there. So if you know somebody who's thinking about selling their condo downtown in that general vicinity there, anywhere, Lodo, Capitol Hill, all that area down there, Governor's Park, all that jazz, please help me out. Give me a call. I need to help Robin find a place here. 720-373-0654. Now, while she's looking to buy something, we do know a lot of people are actually out there thinking about this is the year. Chris, you probably heard a lot of people that have been on the fence thinking now's the time to make their move.
Absolutely. Everybody thinks it's they've got to wait until the bottom happens, and we're past the bottom, so a lot of people are starting to get itchy because they realize it's gone.
You know, it's interesting you should say that, because I have always thought the fastest way for increased business is to have the interest rates go up, which we know they're doing.
And that's exactly what happened last May when things popped up. Everybody started going crazy, realizing that, you know, that those low threes were going to be something that's not going to happen again.
Absolutely. So, you know, this means that if you're thinking about putting your home on the market, you need to kind of get some ideas. And I have some ideas, tips for sellers here. I have about a few points here. First of all, if you are hiring an agent, hopefully you are, because you need a pro in today's world. Honestly, there's just too much liability associated with selling your home yourself. You need to go ahead and find out from your agent. Trust your agent. Learn to trust them. And if you can't trust them, get a different agent. You know, in fact, you know what they should do, Chris? They should call me, don't you think?
Absolutely. Give Cheryl a call.
720-373-0654. But ask your agent to tap into their insight about showing some preparation tips for attracting more motivated buyers. Get some contractor referrals from your agent there for sprucing up your property without busting that budget that you might have. And then ask them about what some of the common expectations and restrictions are to save time and energy during your negotiation process. Now, a lot of times you want your agent to be honest with you, and a lot of times agents aren't always so forthcoming. So let them know it's okay for them to be totally honest with you about what to expect. Another point, outwit the competition with incentives. So make sure that, you know, you are cognizant of what's going on in your own marketplace, and don't hang around when showings occur. And you got to realize one other big thing here. You've got to expect to negotiate. And learn how to cement your existing deal when you get one by still keeping it on the market and taking backup offers, you know? And we'll talk later on about some other opportunities for you in marketing. But stay tuned for more from the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. We'll be right back.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl did an incredible job of creating a virtual tour of our house and property, which was very appealing and professionally done. Cheryl was in constant communication and offered very sound and professional advice.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at DenverRealty.com.
Education, the key to success in life. Red Rocks Institute of Colorado can give you that key. Classes, events, workshops, and webinars. We can help you learn and give you a platform to teach your passion. Red Rocks Institute offers a wide variety of classes from money management, real estate, investments, mortgage, insurance, retirement planning, and more. Red Rocks Institute, an adult education center designed to empower people with knowledge. For more information, go to redrocksinstitute.com.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl understood my needs and focused on the properties that most interested me and helped me determine which property would be worth the investment of a lifetime.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at DenverRealty.com.
It's a big, big house with lots and lots of room. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house. It's my father's house.
Hey, welcome back to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, your host. Hey, you know what? I've got Chris Zadro with W.J. Bradley in the studio here with me today. And today, you know, we're going to be talking with Chris about the mortgage industry here a little bit here. But I have got to tell you guys here, I've got to tell you, this show is all about residential real estate. So if you're thinking about buying or selling or investing, this is the place you want to be. You got questions on it? That's what we love to answer. 720-373-0654. Or go ahead and pop online to DenverRealty.com and you can always connect with us there. You know, Chris, you've been in this business of lending and mortgage money making here for a long, long time, right?
Absolutely. It's almost 18 years.
18 years. Well, I've got something to give you incentive to work to nearly 100. There was an article in the paper.
I don't know if I'll live that long, but let's go for it.
Oh, listen, let me tell you what. This guy, okay, there's an article in the paper here. The guy was an economist with the agricultural department, and he did 30 years in that career.
Wow.
Okay, now, you know, we all typically think, well, I'm 30 years, that's it, I'm done, right? He went on to another 31 years in the mortgage business.
I would have to say that he needs to go talk to a psychologist.
Yes, I think so. Well, he's 106. He worked all the way up until about 100 years old.
Holy cow.
Okay,
wow,
listen.
Wow, wow.
I got to tell you guys, so you stay tuned to this show here because I have got some reasons for you so you're not in that predicament there of working until 100 years old. You know, it's all about building a pension and a retirement plan here. But first, I want to talk to Chris here, and I want you guys to chime in on this whole conversation here a bit because we got a lot of people in this turning market, as we were just talking about here, and you're going to be wanting to maybe make your move, you know, make that buy. And so one of the things that you're going to be finding out, especially online, aside from a bunch of houses, you're also going to find a lot of mortgage information out there. And we get a lot of people that like to play online,
right?
You know, and look for this stuff all on their own time and think they can get that loan online. That is the worst thing you can do. I am not in the lending business. I am a realtor. I'm here to help you buy and sell property. But Chris is. There was an article that I think was in the Smart Lively Weekly, which was showcased in Bloomberg or something here, about people going into the market here and looking at, you know, some of the questions that a loan officer or lending company is going to ask about if you need a loan.
Right.
You know, all loans are not created equal.
Absolutely not. They're all different.
They're all different. So one of the first things things I'm going to ask you guys is this a purchase or a refinance? Is that right, Chris?
Absolutely.
And there's a difference in the rate quote sometimes, isn't there?
There's definitely a difference. I mean, the markets change a little bit, and so now we see, you know, typically a purchase is going to have the most aggressive rate, and then depending on what type of refinance you're doing, that's going to change the rate as well.
Absolutely. So, and another area that has a lot of different subjectivity, I guess, to it is how's your credit?
That tends to be the probably the biggest thing people don't understand. And, you know, there's so many myths around credit reports. And a lot of them were from our parents. I mean, there were things that were done a certain way back in our folks' days.
Mm-hmm.
And nowadays, they're done a little bit differently. That credit market has kind of changed a little bit.
Right. So, but you need to be aware that if you think you have bad credit, you really maybe don't know, because you can do a lot of different things with a lot of different credit scores. And the very first place you need to start is getting a lender-approved credit report pulled. Is that right, Chris?
Absolutely. A lot of people, you know, they'll go out and get the free credit report. There's different models that are used, and the mortgage model is the most stringent one of the group, obviously, because it's such a large loan that's being taken out typically for most people.
Right. But I want you guys to know, if you think that, oh, I don't have good enough credit, or my score is really low, you know what? A, you don't know really what that really means. It's interpreted by the actual mortgage industry and the lender that you're talking to. And, B, you also probably don't know how easy it might be to fix that. Isn't that true?
Absolutely. I see it every single day. People call me and say I have terrible credit, and I pull it and it's fine, and vice versa. People that think they have perfect credit have something on there that they weren't expecting, didn't know about, that sort of thing. So that's probably the biggest first step most people need to take.
And, you know, another thing about looking at what kind of a loan to get for somebody there has to do with what kind of property it is, whether it's a single family home, a condo, or townhome, you know, how that all plays in, or if it's an income property, which we're going to be talking about here a little bit later on. All those kinds of things play a factor into the rate quote. Is that right?
That is correct. That is absolutely correct. Typically, when you start looking in the condo townhome world, those are a little bit riskier as far as the investors are concerned. And so they have a little bit more stringent guidelines to them. But it's fairly easy to navigate if you have somebody that in the industry, obviously like myself, that knows how to go through that process.
Right. And, you know, let's tell everyone, the reason that those are a little bit riskier has a lot to do with the HOAs, the homeowner associations. Is that right?
That's correct. I mean, the HOA actually has a part within side of the development, you know, amenities, they own portions of the ground, all that kind of stuff. So if there was issues, I remember back when the mortgage mess happened, there was a story about a condo down in Florida where there was one person that lived in this high-rise condo.
Oh, yeah.
Like 30-story condo, and he got the tax bill, and it was some atrocious number, you know, a couple million bucks. And obviously, you know, he had to go to court and try to get all that taken care of because nobody else was there to help share that cost.
That's right. You know, and another area that can also affect what kind of a loan you get or what the terms are on that loan, too, is going to be what that property is used for.
Yep.
So if it's like a personal private residence,
yep,
or a vacation home, or an investment property, is that right?
Yeah, typically a primary residence or an owner-occupied residence is going to be a vacation home or a house that you live in. And then obviously if you're going to rent it out, that typically looks like it turns into an investment property at that point.
Mm-hmm. And what that really means is that the government, you know, really wants to get behind people. If you guys heard, you know, President Obama's State of the Union deal the other night, he's really trying to push the American dream of home ownership again, you know, but making sure we don't go down the path that we went down before.
Right.
So, but the point is that you need to go ahead and have, you know, a good products and more aggressive products sometimes for the owner occupant.
Right.
And that's why that if you're going to live in the home, there are more to choose from than if you're looking for the vacation or the investment property.
Correct.
Is that right?
And it's also a bigger, I mean, that tends to be a higher percentage of the market. I mean, most people, when they're buying a house, they're buying it to put their family in, themselves, that sort of thing. So, mm-hmm.
And then also, you know, doesn't it also affect the terms of it too about the purchase price? So, you know, the purchase price of the home there, like if it's $200,000 versus $600,000.
Absolutely.
You know, there's sometimes a break and a cutoff as far as what the rate is going to be like.
Right. Typically, you know, anything under the 417 $1,000 purchase price is considered a non-jumbo conventional loan. Anything above 417 is when you start jumping into the
a little higher interest rate. Yep. Right, yep. A little higher interest rate there. VA loan, what's the maximum VA loan with the preferred deal here? Is that up still?
It's still...
That just changed.
It just changed. I'm trying to think of the number off the top of my head. I want to say it's about... It falls inside the same range as what a jumbo does.
Hey, we got a lot more to share with you here on the Denver Radio Real Estate Show, so get your pen and papers ready because I have got Property Showcase coming right on up there. So get ready here, and we're going to be right back with more to share with you.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl did an incredible job of creating a virtual tour of our house and property, which was very appealing and professionally done. Cheryl was in constant communication and offered very sound and professional advice.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at DenverRealty.com.
Education, the key to success in life. Red Rocks Institute of Colorado can give you that key. Classes, events, workshops, and webinars. We can help you learn and give you a platform to teach your passion. Red Rocks Institute offers a wide variety of classes from money management, real estate, investments, mortgage, insurance, retirement planning, and more. Red Rocks Institute, an adult education center designed to empower people with knowledge. For more information, go to redrocksinstitute.com.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl understood my needs and focused on the properties that most interested me and helped me determine which property would be worth the investment of a lifetime.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at DenverRealty.com.
Our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle of our street.
Hey, welcome back to the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, your host. And you know what? This show is a show all about residential real estate, and I would be completely remiss if I didn't talk about properties. So we've got a couple of great properties to go ahead and share with you here today. If you want to know more about these homes or anything else that's available, two tips for you. One, give me a call, 720-373-0654. Hey, secondly, you want to shop online and tap into the Realtors MLS directly for yourself, you go to DenverRealty.com. That is DenverRealty.com. DenverRealty.com. Click on the Search Homes tab, and that'll put you directly into the Realtors MLS where you can search properties to your heart desire. Now, I've got a great property that is offered for sale by owner, and these folks have been really kind to let me share this with you here today. This, if you're looking for country living, that's a great commute between, say, Denver and Colorado Springs or Monument there. This is just south of Castle Rock, and it is actually in Castle Rock, but it's just south of that on the west side of Highway 25. It sits beautifully on 10 acres of ground. Can you get that one, Chris?
It's beautiful.
It really is. Large contemporary open space. They're four bedrooms, three baths. Like I said, 10 acres, four bay garage, views from every room of the house. Absolutely stunning. You will not find more clean air living than you will out here on this particular property. Hey, it's priced at $535. Yep, that's the current price on the property there, $535 here. And if you want to know more about this property, it's been completely updated, ready to go, just absolutely spectacular, move-in ready. Give me a call, 720-373-0654. Hey, now I've got another property to share with you, too. And this one is located totally the other end of town here, downtown, northwest part of Denver. Real neat Victorian property. It's got a modern flair with preserving the vintage charm. This is a great, 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 great property here. It's got three bedrooms, two baths, and let me think here, a little over 17, almost 1,800 square feet here for this particular property. It's really close to coffee shops, dining shops. It's $10,000 $1,000 below appraised value here, priced at $479,900. $479,900. This is over in the Highland Park area. You want to give me a call at 720-373-0654. What do you think about those photos, Chris?
You know what? I got to say, Cheryl, it looks like not only did you get such a great value on this house, but it looks to me like somebody did some really nice decorating, and just what a great house.
Oh, it's very classic. It's going to really, beautiful. It's going to be a house that you love to talk about. So it's a great, 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 great property. Even 42-inch cabinets in clawfoot tubs. This is a great, great property to go ahead and take a look at. And especially if you're looking for that nice, neat, Victorian urban living and really close to where the action is, as I like to say. So anyway, those are some properties that we've got here. We're going to have another one to share with you, actually a couple more to share with you later on in the show here. But if you want to go ahead and search homes online, go to denverrealty.com. And click on the search homes button there. You'll tap right into the realtor's MLS there directly, and you can search for homes for sale. And if you're thinking about just monitoring what home values are, that's a great place to also go there. So lots of great, great tools there at denverrealty.com. And needless to say, because we are a new show, you know, Chris, well, I have some special radio show offers for people who are selling their home or buying their home. So they need to go ahead and give me a call to talk about that. If you're looking to save some money or get some money back.
Who's looking to do that?
Everybody here. It doesn't last very long, so give us a call here at 720-373-0654. And last but not least here, I'd like to mention one other thing. If you are in the market to buy a home or sell a home, a couple of great classes that are coming your way. Go to, here's another website for you, redrocksinstitute.com, to take a look at the classes on tips and strategies to sell your home today, and another one called What You Need to Know to Buy a Home. They're offered in the middle to end of February there, so you might want to go ahead and take a look at that. Hey, we'll be right back with more from the Denver Radio Real Estate Show here, and get your pen and paper ready here again, because I'm going to be talking about how you can safeguard and build your own self-directed pension with income property and what that's all about, and Chris is going to lend a hand on that. We'll be right back.
If you're looking for your dream home or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl did an incredible job of creating a virtual tour of our house and property, which was very appealing and professionally done. Cheryl was in constant communication and offered very sound and professional advice.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interest. Call Cheryl today, 720-373-0654, or online at DenverRealty.com.
Education, the key to success in life. Red Rocks Institute of Colorado can give you that key. Classes, events, workshops, and webinars. We can help you learn and give you a platform to teach your passion. Red Rocks Institute offers a wide variety of classes from money management, real estate, investments, mortgage, insurance, retirement planning, and more. Red Rocks Institute, an adult education center designed to empower people with knowledge. For more information, go to redrocksinstitute.com.
To the Denver Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, your host on the show. Now, there is a topic I always love to talk about because it's really near and dear to my heart, especially being a realtor and helping people with buying and selling of property. Gosh, I've been doing this for over 30 years, Chris.
I would never have guessed.
And people always say, did you start when you were 12?
I was going to say, I was guessing that it was prior to getting into high school.
Oh, well, anyway, I just have fun with that. But anyway, so you know, you guys, if you happen to have caught the President's State of the Union deal the other night, one of the things he mentioned, you remember, Chris, he mentioned the My IRA thing?
The My IRA, I think, is how it's supposed to be pronounced.
Yeah, well, I don't know. He mentioned the reason this was because so many people in our country don't have a pension plan. And you know, a lot of companies no longer offer those. I mean, it's just not a benefit you get anymore.
Absolutely.
And they do still have the 401s, you know, that kind of a thing there. But the truth is, and here is where I want you guys to pay special attention, I am a firm believer, A, that we're living longer due to modern medicine and food supplements.
Yep.
And of course, the fitness clubs that we all so diligently go to, right? And that, but we're living longer, whether we like it or we don't. Then remember, I just told you about the guy.
106-year-old guy
there. Make room. There's a lot more centurions than there ever used to be.
Absolutely.
But anyway, but we don't have the money. We're afraid that money will
dry
outlive
up.
Our money.
Yeah.
And so I'm big on you creating your own pension plan. And one of the ways you might want to do that is through the wonderful adventure of buying real estate. And you make a lot of loans for different investors. We have investors that are looking for there are different ways of making investments. Fix and flip, meaning you're looking for the fast money.
Short term, right?
Mm-hmm. Or you're also looking for maybe fix it up, hold it for 2 or 3 years, you know, and then turn it around and rent it out in the meantime. That's kind of a fix and slight hold, you might say.
Let other people pay your mortgage for you.
Let other people. And my favorite is the income producing property where it actually is the long term hold. You're in it for the long stretch. And you know what kind of properties sit ideal for that, Chris? Plex.
A plex of some sort.
Right. Now, plex, guys, we're talking about a duplex, a triplex, a fourplex. And there are plexes that are higher than that. But, Chris, you're going to tell us why we don't want to go over four.
Yeah, usually when you start going over that four, you start dealing with commercial.
Yeah, you're dealing with commercial qualifying, commercial rates. It's not as easy to market and sell later. So when you're doing this, you want to make sure that as an investor, you're positioning yourself right for the sale game down the road. But let me give you an idea. This is a fourplex that happens to be available right now. It's not been on the market that long. In Lakewood, you guys, not far from where the new light rail is
light
going.
Rail? Oh, absolutely.
And I'm going to tell you something. That light rail is going to go ahead and allow us to go ahead and have higher rents in areas there. So this one is priced at $410. The rents are really low right now. I think they should be closer to around $900 to $1,000 for a 2-bedroom, 1-bath unit, given this location. Plus, this thing is all brick.
Wow.
All right. Now, let me tell you what I did some research here from a place called apartmentratings.com. Do you guys know what the average 2-bedroom rent is in Denver? Right now, it's $1,148 a month.
Wow.
$1,148. Now, that depends on are you doing the high amounts from the southeast section or the low amounts from north or wherever it is. But anyway, you know, $1,148 is a ballpark average here. But I think this particular complex, it ought to be somewhere between $900 and $1,000.
So Cheryl, let's put that in perspective for people. So somebody owned that house
fourplex,
for 5 years. That's $55,000 roughly that they are paying down on that mortgage.
Absolutely. And not only that, listen, you guys, it's going to cost you, say, 25% down. So we'll use round numbers.
Absolutely.
So we'll call it $100,000. I want you to pretend for just a second you have $100,000 to invest someplace. You got to go make that money work for you. You have two choices by and large. And that really is the stock market or in real estate. If you invest in the stock market, I'm not going to tell you what that return is, but you know, I can tell you one thing, it's not going to be as good as in real estate. If you go ahead and look at the rents and the way rents are calculated here and the value of property from an investor standpoint here, that same property will go ahead and give you guys, get this, around, it'll give you a return on your investment every year of around $21,000.
Wow.
And that's after the mortgage is paid. Now, granted, you do have a few other little things that you have to cash flow and factor in there, but that is a heck of a return. That actually equates to just a little over 20% return on that same $100,000. Wow. Well, I could talk more about that, but you guys know what? Yes, you do. You need to call me, 720-373-0654. I'm going to tell you a little bit more then when you call me about how to analyze investment property, let alone any other property. But really quick, I got one more property. It's a single family home near Baker's Historic District. Really cute property, priced at $261,000. Great for the starter home buyer. Over 1,500 square feet. And it's if you buy this home, get this. It's a 2-bedroom, 2-bath home, over 1,500 square feet, Baker's Historic District, cute as a whistle, really great shape here. If you were to buy this using an FHA loan, say at 4.25% with, say, 3.5% down, about $9,000, that payment is only about $1,238 a month. Call me, 720-373-0654, and we'll take care of your needs. Talk to you next week. Bye.
You've been listening to Denver Radio Real Estate with Cheryl Garlock, a show about all things real estate and home-related for Denver and Colorado. Go to denverrealty.com to sign up for special offers and events. Listen to past shows, read educational articles, and find links to all your home and real estate needs. Cheryl would love to hear from you. For questions and show ideas, email info@denverrealty.com.
He's a rockin' on Bob, a knockin' near the house. He's a rockin' on Bob, a knockin' near the house. He's a rockin'.